10. Naruto's Ramen Obsession. I.R.L. Naruto's life revolves around ramen. He loves the stuff. He's even formulated a rather special philosophy on this particular food, where ramen signifies the act of both loving and being loved by someone. Wow! The root of Naruto's crazy noodle obsession can be traced to the shop at Chiraku, which is cited for being Naruto's favorite ramen. There, Naruto has grown quite close with the owner, Taki, as well as his daughter, Aom, who both view Naruto as their favorite customer. But there's more to this shop than meets the eye. It's a real place. Like real, as in IRL. Ichiraku is an actual shop in Kyushu, Japan. In fact, it's located near the university where author Masashi Kishimoto went. 9. Naruto likes spirals, spirals, and more spirals. If you haven't noticed, spirals abound in Naruto, especially in terms of the titular character himself. Just look at the back of Naruto's original orange outfit. This isn't just a coincidence. If you were proficient in Japanese or a huge ramen fan, then you'd probably know that Naruto is short for Naruto Maki, a kind of kamaboko, which is basically a type of Japanese processed seafood that's specially prepared. Why is this important? Naruto Maki has a special design, a pink spiral design used as a topping for ramen. And as you're well aware, Naruto really likes ramen a lot. And that is probably downplaying it. Still not convinced? Just look at Naruto's family name, Uzumaki. It can mean maelstrom and whirlpool. But wait, there's more. If you were to combine his first name, Naruto, with the first three letters of his family name, Yuzu, and then threw in some letters, what do you get? Bibidi bobidi dot Naruto no Yuzushio. And Naruto no Yuzushio translates to Naruto whirlpools, which were named after the city in the Tokushima. 8. Was Naruto a Jonin level shinobi all along? What Gaku was to Naruto is what Kamehameha is to Cage Bunshin. The shadow clone technique is kinda Naruto's thing. Or, at least it was, before Naruto started getting really crazy powerful, using Rasengan, among others. But before all that insanity, Cage Bunshin was his first signature attack. This jutsu, however, can do so much more than just create multiple versions of the user. As Naruto learned during his elemental affinity training, a shadow clone user will absorb the knowledge and experience that each shadow clone gained once they have poofed out of existence. In other words, it's a great way to expedite one's training. But what's so intense about this jutsu is that in order to conjure it, the user needs to have a high amount of chakra reserves. As such, it's considered a Jonin level jutsu. And seeing as Naruto has a seemingly endless supply of chakra, and can perform the technique, means he can do a Jonin level jutsu. 7. Naruto's Doubter Book Inconsistency. Who doesn't enjoy attacks that can cause destruction at an exponential level, at least, when you're not the target? Such is the case with the truth-seeking balls, which are capable of transforming the victim into dust, where transformation signifies obliteration. Anyway, Naruto gains the ability to create 9 of these hand-sized, black-colored orbs. Naruto is also the recipient of Hagoromo Otsutsuki's powers, the legendary Sage of Six Paths. Sure, that's cool and all, but it's important to note that both of these powers contain yin-yang release. This is a problem because, apparently, in this fourth data book, yin release is not listed as a nature Naruto has mastered. Does that mean Naruto doesn't actually have those aforementioned abilities? Or was it just an error? From that data book, the unknown fact you didn't know is that Naruto can perform yin-yang release techniques, but has only mastered yang release, not yin release. 6. A hairdo of champions. If, for whatever reason, you wanted to see if Naruto looked like another ninja from Konoha, you'd have a great deal of trouble doing so because Naruto is one unique-looking dude. If anything, you'd be better off comparing him to another shinobi, personality-wise. The obvious choice would be Konohamaru Sarutobi. Heck, Konohamaru has declared Naruto to be both his rival and role model. But that's neither here nor there. Anyway, if you are going to take on the difficult endeavor of seeing who Naruto looks like in Konoha, the last person you would turn to would be Konkuro. Konkuro's fashion statement alone makes him an unlikely candidate. Just look at that face paint. Sure, his outfit may be derived from traditional Bunraku puppeteer costumes, but we're doing lookalikes, not history comparisons. However, Naruto does look the most like Konkuro. How, you ask? When Konkuro takes off his hood, you'll notice that he has a very similar hairstyle. Heck, it's exactly the same. The only difference is the color. 5. The Naruto who begot Naruto. We think it's safe to say that even people who don't care about Naruto know that the story revolves around a human boy. Sure, they might not know that he's a Jinchuriki, nor would they know that Jinchuriki are humans who have tailed beasts sealed inside them, but it's easy to tell that he's a member of the human race. However, here's a little fact that many Naruto fans, and therefore non-fans, don't know. Before Naruto was a human ninja kid, creator Masashi Kishimoto originally published a one-shot manga in Akamaru Jump on August 18, 1997 about a character named Naruto, who wasn't really Naruto, at least, not the Naruto you know. Instead of having a demon fox sealed within him, Naruto was actually a demon fox, who just so happened to live his life as a human boy. However, in this first Naruto story, that isn't to say that there wasn't a fox with nine tails wreaking havoc on the ninja world. Such a creature did exist, and that creature was Naruto's father. Conflict. Interestingly, Naruto, the actual fox, lived a very similar life, compared to that of Naruto, the Jinchuriki. For some reason, Fox Naruto chose to live in the very village where Daddy decided to wreak havoc on. Knowing who Fox Naruto's dad was, the villagers obviously didn't like Naruto. They understandably feared him as well. Sounds familiar? If that bums you out, let's focus on some happy stuff. Fox Naruto, like human Naruto, knew the Henge transformation technique, whereby Fox Naruto would transform into an attractive young woman, but he could also turn into a bat. 4. Naruto, the Kitsune. If you're hyper aware of Japanese mythology, then you probably already know this. But for the vast majority of us who only nerd out over mythos in anime that the anime actually references directly with words, then this might come to you as a shock. Naruto's development found quite a bit of inspiration from the Japanese Kitsune, a type of yokai, or spiritual entity. Why does this matter? Because Kitsune is oftentimes translated as the fox spirit. Naruto's Kyuubi is a fox demon. Of course, anyone can draw comparisons to anything and everything. That's why we're using Macquarie University's PhD candidate Amy Plum as reference, giving some validation to this particular section. Let's do some more paralleling. There's another type of Kitsune in Japanese mythology known as the Nenko, which is an invisible spirit that possesses humans. Sure, Kurama didn't possess Naruto on purpose. He was sealed inside. But there's some similarity there. A Nenko can also only be perceived by the human it's possessing. Okay, well, we know that anyone can see a Kyuubi. But then again, not really. No one can actually see a Kyuubi that's sealed inside the Jinchuriki, unless the Jinchuriki summons its power, but the Jinchuriki can see it. And by see, we're referencing all that footage when Naruto talks to Kurama from behind those giant bars. Here's one other detail. Kitsune, in Japanese lore, are noted for having up to nine tails. Kurama is known as the Nine Tails because he has .9 tails. Maybe Amy Plum is on to something. 3. Insane growth spurt. Back in the day when Naruto and the anime only designated Konoha 11 were just starting as academy students, Naruto was the shortest one. In part 1, he is documented to being 145.3 centimeters. The tallest Konoha 11 at that time was Rock Lee, who stood at a height of 158.5 centimeters. But by the end, something happened. Naruto became ostensibly the tallest, going through some sort of crazy growth spurt. Naruto was said to be 180 centimeters. Meanwhile, Rock Lee only stands at 177 centimeters. However, there's an interesting discrepancy that no one has really touched upon. Many sources cite Naruto as being initially the shortest of all Konoha 11 before ultimately becoming the supposed tallest. However, Shinobara, a Konoha 11 ninja, is documented at the end as being 182 centimeters. So does that mean Naruto was the shortest and became the second tallest? Or is that 182 centimeters wrong, too? Bowel problems? Naruto doesn't really take care of himself. Endeavoring to generate such a list of how he doesn't would be suicidal. The ones that pertain to this particular section are Naruto's horrific eating habits. Sure, with Naruto being a kid and or adolescent jerk with no parents, it's understandable that he wouldn't bother adopting healthier routines, especially when doing so requires extra effort. By eating poorly and not taking care of his body, Naruto has done a lot to his digestive system. One of the ways in which his body negatively reacts to these pastimes, which include being a glutton of ramen as well as drinking expired milk, is through his stomach region revolting. As a result, Naruto has experienced bowel problems at various times throughout the anime, manga. Without going into detail, because it's disgusting, you can find Naruto wrestling with unpleasant bodily functions in episode 3, when he's in this forest of death during the Chuunin exam, twice during the Baikishu arc and once during episode 192. 1. The relationship between Naruto and Luffy. A lot of anime, manga fans are aware of the war, or, to be more concise, the competition between Naruto and One Piece. However, it's not much of a stretch to say that many don't know that there are some interesting correlations between both shonen, especially between Luffy, from One Piece, and Naruto. For one, the author of One Piece, Eiichiro Oda, stated that Sanji was originally going to be named Naruto. But all of that changed when Naruto was about to become a series. Best to avoid confusion, right? Naruto also made a background appearance on the cover of One Piece's 766 chapter. If you take a look at the cover, you'll notice that there's a person behind Nami who's wearing a chain pao with the Konoha symbol. That character is implied to be Naruto. As you can see, Naruto was eating meat on the cover, which is Luffy's favorite food, while Luffy is eating ramen, Naruto's favorite food. Plus, it should be noted that the chapter with said cover was released during the same week as the final two Naruto manga chapters. Also, in the 700th chapter of the Naruto manga, the symbol of the Straw Hat Pirates, as seen in One Piece, is griffited onto something that belongs to Naruto, which implies another fact about him and which we can't elaborate on since we don't want to be a major spoiler. Better start watching and reading then.
Subscribe for more.